You're okay. Relax, you're okay. What a lot of people now identify as major life problems are really the natural ebbs and flows of life. Sometimes you're up and sometimes you're down. And for some reason, we seem to have forgotten that that's okay. Let's say you have low self-esteem and a general self-loathing about yourself. You believe everything you do sucks and that you're more or less screwed in life. Wanting to stop believing such things only serves as more evidence of how screwed up you are. In external aspects of one's identity, desire is useful. Want to run faster? Set a goal, then go out and achieve it. Want to start a business? There are measurable benchmarks you can reach. You just have to want it enough. But want to stop being anxious and stop procrastinating on those goals? Well, then wanting to stop being anxious about them is likely to just make you more anxious. Self-acceptance is the way out of the conundrum, but it's counterintuitive. Paradoxically, accepting that you're just not a confident person and you're always going to feel a little off around other people will begin to make you feel more comfortable and less anxious around others. You won't judge yourself, and you'll then feel less judged by them as well. Accepting that you have a tendency to get depressed and that some people are just happier than you and that's fine will, ironically, make you a happier and more accepting person. After all, some of the most important people in history were depressives. Many of us are inundated with so much information at all hours of the day that it's easy to get a skewed vision of society. Everyone else is fit. Everyone else is happy. Everyone else is successful. Everyone else is getting dates and having sex. But for some reason, you're not. What sells TV time and what gets passed around the internet are the exceptional situations, the easy solutions, the magic pills for perfection. It's human nature to always look for perfection or for something greater and better than ourselves. But when you're presented with something greater and better than yourself over and over and over again, all hours of the day, all days of the week, it's easy to internalize that there's something wrong with you. Ironically, the self-help industry is a culprit here as well. Most people get depressed at some point in their lives. Most people get dumped at some point and struggle getting over their ex. Most people feel insecure about their sexuality at some point. Everyone has family problems. Many people grow up in abusive situations. Tons of people have low self-esteem and dependency issues. Almost everybody wishes they were more successful and more motivated. These things suck, but they're not new, and they're definitely not unique. Don't get me wrong, this is not an excuse to do nothing about your problems. It just means that you should stop trying to be perfect. You never will be. Emotional issues never completely go away. There's an old Buddhist adage, you are already perfect as you are, yet you can always be better. Perfection is not some endpoint you achieve, but rather the process of improvement itself. No matter how much you improve yourself and your life, there will always be room for more growth and less suffering. There's no final goal. The perfect self we all envision does not actually exist. As Gertrude Stein said, quote, there's no there, end quote. It never ends. What changes is your acceptance of your place in the process. I suck at this, but that's okay. As long as I'm working on it, it's okay. Perfection is the process of improvement itself. Perfection is the innate drive for endless expansion, growth, and completion. We're already there, and we've always been there. We're okay. We can be better, but we're okay.
If you found the video informative, then hit the like button, comment your thoughts down, and share to spread the word. Also, a sub to the channel would be motivating. Just wait, we also have over 300 videos to watch, just click left or right. Keep inspiring.